Higgins. If there's any mishap at the embassy tonight, if Miss Doolittle suffers any embarrassment, whatever, it's on your head alone. I've been begging you to call off this experiment ever since Ascot.
Eliza can do anything. Suppose she's discovered. Suppose she makes another ghastly mistake.
There'll be no horses at the ball, Pickering.
Think how agonizing it would be. God, if anything happened tonight, I don't know what I'd do. You can always rejoin your regiment. Higgins, this is no time for flippancy. The way you've driven her these last 6 weeks has exceeded all the bounds of common sensibility. Have some port. It will quieten your nerves.
Mr. Higgins, the car is ready.
Thank you, Mrs. Pierce. Are you helping Eliza?
Yes, sir.
Help her indeed. I warned you about those French designers. You should have gone to a good English store where you knew everybody was on our side. Have a little port?
No, thank you.
It'll quieten your nerves.
No, thank you.
Are you so sure she'll retain all you've hammered into her?
I told you, I hope so.
Suppose she doesn't.
Then I lose my bet.
You know what I can't stand about you, Higgins? In a moment like this, with so much at stake, it's utterly indecent that you don't need a little port. Watch out, the girl. You act as if she doesn't matter at all.
Obviously, of course she matters. What do you think we've been doing all these months? What could matter more than to take a human being and change her into another human being by taking a new speech for her? Why, it's filling up the greatest gulf that separates class from class and soul from soul. Oh, she matters immensely.
Torrington and Master Torrington.
Professor Zoltan Carpathy. Colonel Hugh Pickering.
Mrs. Higgins.
Excuse me.
Well, she got by the first hurdle. The ambassador's wife was completely captivated.
Yes, I know. I've had several people asking who she is. Do tell me what happened.
Higgins said, Madam Ambassador, may I introduce Miss Eliza Doolittle? And the Madam Ambassador said, how do you do? And Eliza came back with, how do you do?
And was that all?
Oh, no. When it was my turn, both the Ambassador and his wife said, Colonel Pickering, who is that captivating creature with Professor Higgins?
Well, what did you say?
Well, I was stopped for a moment. Then I collected myself, and I said, Eliza Doolittle.
Oh, that was quick.
Hey, Mrs. Higgins, do you think Eliza will make it?
Oh, I do hope so. I've grown terribly fond of that girl.
Professor Henry Higgins.
Ah, maestro, maestro. You remember me?
No, I don't. Who the devil are you?
I am your pupil. Your first, best, and greatest pupil. I am Zoltan Carpathy, this marvelous boy. I have made your name famous throughout Europe. You teach me poetics. You cannot forget me.
Why don't you shave?
I have not your imposing stance, your figure, your brow. No one will recognize me if I shave.
Where did you get all these old coins?
Decorations for language. The Queen of Transylvania is here this evening.
indispensable to her at these international parties. I know everyone in Europe. I speak 32 languages. No imposter escaped my detection. And now, Professor, you must introduce me to this marvelous creature you're escorting this evening.
She fascinates everyone. Not since Mrs. Langtree came to London.
His Excellency, Dr. Themistocles Stephanos.
This so-called Greek diplomat pretends he cannot speak a word of English. He does not fool me. He's the son of a Yorkshire watchmaker. He speaks English so villainously that he dare not utter a word of it without betraying his origins. I help him to pretend, but I make him pay through the nose. I make them all pay. I look forward to meeting your lady.
Higgins!
Where is Eliza?
Oh, last minute adjustment. I say, Higgins, let's not risk it. Let's collect her and leave immediately.
Yes, do you think it wise to stay?
Stay? Why not?
Miss Eliza Doolittle.
Ah, Professor, you must introduce us.